Good morning, one and all. I'm happy to announce the arrival of our guest of honor, along with our principal, our headmaster, headmistress. I would request all to kindly stand. Put your hands together.
A very good morning to one and all present here. It is my honor to welcome you all to celebrate this momentous occasion with us. The third Junior School Prefect's Investiture Ceremony for the academic year 2024-2025. This ceremony marks the official induction of the students who have demonstrated exceptional leadership qualities and will now play a vital role in shaping our school experience. Integrity is the foundation of all great leadership. As Simon Sinek said, leadership is not about titles, positions, or diplomas. It's about what you do and how you inspire people. Today, we honor a group of exceptional students chosen as prefects. This ceremony marks a significant milestone in their leadership journey. We extend a special welcome to our governing body members, our esteemed guest of honor, Mr. Jamie Jacob. I kindly request Mr. Jacob to come up on stage. Let's put our hands together, ladies and gentlemen. At this juncture, I would now like to invite our guide to kindly present sir with the token of our gratitude for gracing us with his presence and giving us his valuable time. We also welcome our dear principal, Mr. Julian Liu, our headmaster, Mr. Ralph Russell, our headmistress, Mrs. Melissa Fernandez, our junior college coordinator, Mrs. Faith, our senior school coordinators, Mrs. Kurian and Mrs. Khandelwal, our sectional coordinators of the junior school, Mrs. Neha Pillay, Mr. Sean Francis, Mrs. N. Marion, and Mr. Bajon. I would also like to welcome our parents, teachers, and our dear students to the third Junior School Prefect's Investiture Ceremony. This ceremony marks a significant milestone, not only for our newly appointed prefects, but for our entire institution. Witnessing this event reminds us of the immense trust and confidence bestowed upon them. These students, meticulously chosen for their achievements and potential, are poised to make a positive impact on our junior school. Today, they officially assume the mantle of leadership, inspiring their peers and setting a positive example. From this day forward, they will be beacons of inspiration and guidance for their fellow students, leading by example and fostering a spirit of collaboration within our school community. As we gather here today, let us pause for a moment of prayer, a chance to find comfort, direction, and a sense of unity amid this special occasion. As we embark on this new chapter with our new prefects, let us offer a prayer for their wisdom, strength, and guidance. I request Mrs. Deepa Pote to say a word of prayer by invoking our Lord's blessings on this special day. May I now request the congregation to kindly stand.
Today's scripture reading is taken from Psalm 95. Come, let us rejoice in the Lord's presence. Let us celebrate with joyous songs to the rock of our salvation. Let us approach him with thankful hearts and honor him with music and praise. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you today with hearts full of gratitude and joy as we gather together to invest our new prefects. We thank you for the gifts and talents you have bestowed upon them, and for the opportunity to serve and lead within our community. We ask for your blessing upon the ceremony and upon each prefect being invested today. Grant them wisdom, courage, and compassion as they take on their new responsibilities. May they be guided by your light and strive to lead with integrity and humility. Help them to inspire their peers, uphold the values of our school, and make a positive difference in the life of others. May their leadership be a reflection of your love and grace. This we ask in the name of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, ma'am. I will now request Mr. Fonseca to kindly take over and lead our junior prefects in.
Thank you. Dio, do you promise to uphold the rules, the regulations, and the good tradition of the school and defend its honor? And do you pledge to do your duty faithfully, putting the school and the nation before you?
I do.
I hereby commission you as the prefect of the junior school of the Bishop's Co-Ed School, Lundri. May God bless you and give you the strength and the courage to do your duty faithfully.
Thank you, sir. Requesting you to kindly wait back, sir, and give away the badges and ties to our newly elected prefects. I now take this opportunity and request Ms. Sharon Wadding to lead us through the program.
Thank you, ma'am. Ladies and gentlemen, parents, teachers, and students, it is with great pleasure that we introduce the children of O'Connor House who have demonstrated exceptional leadership and dedication to their community. They have shown that they are truly worthy of this recognition, and we are honored to acknowledge their achievements. Please join me in congratulating the students of the O'Connor House as they come forward to receive their well-deserved badges. Let us celebrate their success and encourage them to continue striving for excellence. As our O'Connor House motto says, every child, every chance. We now call upon our prefects from the O'Connor House to come up and collect their badges. We begin with the girls. Konita Hussain. Konita
With dedication and honesty, standing out for what is right.
right even when it is hard. As the students of the Young House embody the spirit of their motto, building better citizens for tomorrow, please join me in welcoming our newly appointed Young House prefects who have earned their badges through hard work and kindness. Let us commence with the girls, Vrita Mali.
Thank you. special prayer. O Heavenly Father, bless the prefects of the school. Give them an understanding of what is true, honorable, and right. A willing heart to serve their school faithfully with courage and love in fulfilling their duty. And may all the members of the school, through them, be drawn into a close unity of good purpose for thy name's sake. Amen.
Thank you, ma'am. The role of a prefect carries significant responsibility. As they prepare to guide and inspire their peers, we are fortunate to have with us today a remarkable individual who embodies the qualities of leadership. I now request Ms. Simran Marian to introduce our esteemed guest of honor, Mr. Jeeu Jacob, for today's ceremony.
Good morning, everyone. It is my privilege to introduce our guest of honor, Mr. Jeeu Jacob. With an impressive 16 years of expertise in the banking and finance domain, Mr. Jacob currently serves as the Assistant Vice President at Barclays in the IT sector, Pune. His skills in business analysis, software designs, and successful delivery of large-scale, complex programs have significantly contributed to the operational efficiency of the bank. Mr. Jacob holds a robust educational background in engineering, in information technology, and a diploma in computer science. He is passionate about creating sophisticated software products that drive success and efficiency in the banking sector. Beyond his professional achievements, Mr. Jacob is an avid reader of technology articles, always staying up to date with the latest trends. He also cherishes quality time spent with his family and enjoys cycling with his children. A perfect balance of professional excellence and personal growth. We express our immense gratitude to Mr. Jeeu Jacob for being with us today and sharing this invaluable insight. Thank you, Mr. Jacob, for inspiring us all. Sir, we kindly request you to please come forward and address the gathering.
Respected governing body, respected principal, respected headmistress, respected coordinators, respected faculty members, dear students and parents. I stand before you today with a heart full of gratitude on the occasion of prefects in this institutional ceremony. My heartfelt congratulations to our newly appointed prefects. I'm grateful to the school management for giving me this opportunity to address this gathering. On this occasion, I would like to elucidate a few qualities of a leadership that have influenced my career in a leadership capacity. The first and foremost is the humility. The greatest thing when we are planning for success is to be humble. Humility or being humble is recognizing my limitations and valuing others. Make humility a core part of your character. Being humble doesn't mean that we are weak or not courageous, but but it fosters trust and respect. Always remember, when pride comes, then the disgrace. Let's not get trapped by the pride. The second is the courage. Identify our fears and gradually expose to them. We can never overcome a fear without facing it. Am I the one who always say, if I take up this challenge, would it be successful? These are the seeds of fear within us. Discard the thoughts about the outcome and just attempt it. Integrity. Integrity is being honest and transparent to others and adhere to moral principles. It is not necessary that a leader is always right or correct. Admit it whenever we are wrong. Wisdom and decision making. Wisdom is a judicious application of knowledge in a situation with discernment. In essence, knowing that tomato is a fruit, and the wisdom is not to put tomato in a fruit salad. Time management. Establish a specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound goals in your day-to-day life, and start achieve them. In corporate life, we usually call it as a SMART technique, you know, S-M-A-R-T. The final one I would like to say is refrain from idle chatters. I mean, idle chat or gossip, usually call it as, is definitely a blocker for your personal growth. Dear briefers, upon completing your studies from this school, you will take pride in identifying as Bishop Pikes. You are the guardians of this school's reputation. Take risk, step out of your comfort zone, and challenge yourself to grow and learn. Believe in your ability to make a positive impact within your school community and beyond. Be bold, be compassionate, and be the change you want to see in this world. Thank you for your dedication and commitments to become the leaders this world needs. Most importantly, take your God by your side. If God is with us, who can be against us? Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We are incredibly grateful for your insightful and motivational message. Isn't it a beautiful day, ladies and gentlemen? As we continue our program today, let's take a moment to enjoy a musical performance by our junior school choir, a song that captures the simple joys of a lovely day. Let us pause for a moment to appreciate the sunshine in the sky, a reminder to slow down, enjoy the little things in life, and maybe even pretend to fly a kite. Let us all welcome our junior school choir as they present the song, Such a Beautiful Day.
And so it's pouring. Thank you. Your melodious voices truly set the tone for this special occasion. I now request Mrs. Bolde to kindly deliver the vote of thanks.
Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not gifting it. A very good morning to one and all. As we come to the close of this significant occasion, it is my privilege to extend our heartfelt gratitude to everyone who made today's program a memorable success. I, Mrs. Deepa Bolde, on behalf of the Bishop's Co-ed School Hundri and the entire fraternity of our institution, would like to extend my most sincere gratitude to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. On behalf of my school, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our esteemed guest of honor, Mr. Gino Jacob, for gracing this event with your presence. Your valuable words and insights have undoubtedly left a lasting impact on our new prefects and the entire school community. We are truly blessed and fortunate to have Mr. Julian Luke, an exceptional principal, serve your passion and dedication to our school for qualities we all admire. Thank you for your unwavering support and guidance, which has been instrumental in shaping our school's success. I now request our headmistress, Mrs. Melissa Fernandez, our headmaster, Mr. Ralph Russell, Mrs. Bailey, the junior sectional coordinators, along with the house masters and house mistresses of each house, to please come forward on stage and present our principal, Mr. Julian Bloom, with a bouquet as a token of gratitude. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's give a big round of applause for our principal, Mr. Julian Bloom. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank our respected headmaster, Mr. Ralph Russell, for his continuous guidance at all times. I would also like to express my profound gratitude to our headmistress, Mrs. Melissa Fernandez, who has a bird's eye for every detail and exhibits a remarkable ability to note the smallest intricacies in any situation. Thank you, ma'am, for being the catalyst that stimulated us to do our best and standing as a pillar of strength, and for always going above and beyond for the betterment of our school. We deeply appreciate your steadfast dedication and visionary leadership, which has created a nurturing and thriving environment for all of us. A heartfelt gratitude to all the sectional coordinators, class coordinators, house masters, house mistresses, house teachers and staff, sports secretary, Mr. Milroy Fernandez and his team, Art Department, Music Department, Estate Department, and Computer Department for enhancing this event with the touch of Madras. Ladies and gentlemen, please put up this is a great show with a lot of support with all hands coming up together this morning. Savor the moment, treat yourself. Cheers to great times like this. Great food perfectly complements a great program. A special thank you to Mr. Joel Singhmani for arranging delightful snacks for this program. Our sincere gratitude goes to all parents, guardians, and well-wishers for your rock-solid support and for being partners in this journey with us. Thank you for believing in us. Your faith in us has been the cornerstone of achievements through every step of our journey. We would like to acknowledge the students of Class 5 for being seated so quietly and attentively and being such a wonderful audience this morning. Finally, to our newly appointed prefects, for our future budding leaders, hearty congratulations. Let us pledge to uphold the values of our school and work diligently to create a positive and nurturing environment for your peers. Last but not the least, thank you to each and every one of you for contributing to the success of this year's Junior Schools Prefect Investiture and making this event a memorable one. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I now request everyone to kindly stand as we sing our school song, followed by the national anthem.
Yeah.
I request everyone to kindly be seated. A proud moment indeed for our dear parents. I request the parents of the prefect body to pull up the sash and badge for your child. I also request the staff to kindly help out. Parents, please note, kindly be prompt and quick, as after that, our prefect body will have a combined photograph with our principal, headmaster, headmistress, our guest of honor, and administrative heads.